Hi, it's me, Rasheed Ogunlaru, code speaker and author, and welcome to this, the March episode of Catch the Coach. And March is a powerful, profound month. Why? Because it's the start of spring. And spring means so many different things to so many people. It's a time of the start of this new season. It's about growth. It's about possibility. It's about blossoming. It is about nature. It is about things becoming lighter. It is about growth, birth, rebirth. It is a religious time. It's a spiritual time for many people. It's a very practical time. It marks the end of the financial year. In many parts of the world, it is a time where lots of people think about things like spring cleaning their house, clearing the decks in terms of their work. It is a very powerful and a very, very profound time. And my theme this issue is that I wanted to talk about was space. And the reason why I want to talk about space, because space has so much to do with it. For you, it might be a time where you're thinking, okay, I want to get outdoors more. I want to get out into nature. It might be a time where you are thinking about, okay, this is the time when I'm going to clear the house, going to clear the office and so on. You might be thinking, actually, I need more headspace, or I've got new projects that I need to be able to make room for, and I'm shutting down old projects. There's so many different elements to it. But one of the things that I also find is that for many people I coach in leadership and in their career and in their businesses, is that last few years have been so tough that many people, the thing that they lack is headspace, thinking space. It's so busy. And I have a saying that you can't pour more water into a full cup without causing a spillage. So what we're going to do now is pause. We're going to breathe. We're going to create space. Because there's a link between space, energy, and time. They all interact. So my tip for the month is about making space, clearing the decks, making way. So that might be, you might be wanting to do what I did earlier on today. I did the first wave of my clearing some space in the office, was clearing out old files, old paperwork and so on. It might be that you want to begin with clearing things in terms of your home. It might be recycling things, getting rid of old things, letting things kind of go. Because one of the things about making space that can be profound, not just does it give you more space, physical space, it actually often gives you more headspace as well as you let go of things. It's extraordinary how hanging on to many things can still have an energetic connection to us. So on that note, don't just clear the office, don't just clear the files, don't just clear things at home, but also in terms of the computer. Are the files, are the documents, are the desktop that you can make more clear so that you could be clearing away lots of emails, because there's something about that clearing space that gives you more room to breathe. And remember, you can't pour more water into a full cup without causing that spillage. So space is our tip for this month. Because as we begin to make space and feel that space and begin to enjoy that space, we suddenly begin to have room to bring more things in. And as we clear things away, we suddenly have got more room, we've got more space as we put things that we no longer need to have in the front away, or whatever it might well be. We suddenly find that we have got more space. But I want you to think about, what does space mean to you? And in what ways that you need to make space? Is it for you? It might be for you. It's a bit like here. You might be thinking, actually, for me, it's about that time that I have with nature. It is about getting outdoors more. For me, that's how I feel that I connect. Is it for you that you're wanting to make space for the things that you enjoy, for your hobbies and pastimes? Maybe that's what space means and impacts and is relevant for you. So you might be thinking, you know what? I'm going to reconnect to the time to get out there and play my tennis or my paint or whatever. I was running a session the other day and one of the people said that she really loved to paint, and we were exploring what are the ways in which you can make space. If you really struggle to make space, one of the things that I highly recommend that you do is have a 10-minute review, 10-minute weekly review for you, for your career or for your team or whatever it is that you're looking at. Just sometimes just taking 10 minutes just give you an opportunity to pause, breathe, and reflect. So I'm going to invite you just to take a minute with me now, just to pause, just to breathe, just to feel settled, So just feel the connection of your foot, your feet on the ground, if you're lucky enough to have feet that you can be grounded, or notice how it is that you connect with the earth, the bits of your body as you connect with the earth. Breathing in through the nose, because we're breathing in new inspiration, then we're breathing out through the mouth, expelling all that air, expelling, letting go. So breathing in, letting new things in. We're noticing all the things we hold on to, and now we're letting all go. If there's any thoughts, let them just pass. Just be present here. Be present with your body. Just letting all the thoughts go. Letting all the things that happened last season gently float away. And just being present with yourself in the here and now. Just pause. Breathe a nice, deep, greedy breath in. And let all that out. Just coming back into the space. That was probably less than a minute, but it's an opportunity for us to support, breathe, and reconnect. So my theme for this month is space. As you begin to create space, you'll become more clear. You'll have more room. You'll be more aware. Your perspective will increase. The energy that you have will increase as you're beginning to make space for your wellness, for your exercise, for your nutrition, for loved ones. And you can become aware of, okay, what are the things I'm wanting to let in? What are the things that I need to work on? What are the things that I need to prioritize? But first things first, my tip for this month is all about making space, making way. All the best to you for the month ahead. Take good care. Lots of love from me, Rashid.